Bhante Katapunna came from Texas, Houston.
Excuse me. So actually, in Houston, we had these interfaith services, and we had so many faiths actually participated. I mean, for the event, Baha'i, Hindu, Buddhist, Christian, I mean, Christian, Methodist, Catholics, or whatever. So, and then also we had this even Jainism and Zoroastrianism. So many these different types of Muslims as well. So participated in this event. It's a very meaningful event that together to understand each other and then to have understanding and actually living peacefully together. So today, on November 20th, Saturday 2021, is a very historical event, especially for here, mine. So this event is a grand opening ceremony of the Father John's Learning Kindness Meditation Center. I like to call it Center of Church, okay? So the Center of Church. So, and then as well as the Interfaith Thanksgiving services now. So it is my great and a pleasure, honor to be given this rare opportunity to give a talk on this Interfaith Thanksgiving service. So the theme for today is kataññu katavedi. So I read it, somebody had given me this kataññu katavedi. Kataññu katavedi actually is a Pali word. If you know Pali and Theravada Buddhism, they use Pali language. So the meaning translated in English is actually grateful and gratitude. Grateful and gratitude. So in Chinese, I would like to say a few words. 知恩, 感恩. So maybe in Vietnamese, 感恩. I just only know a little, so just 感恩. So this few is the same thing. And we are grateful and thankful to all friends in the States and abroad also. And most importantly, your presence here as of John has said that without your presence here, it could not be, materialized. There are only a few people here. So if your presence here and give your great support and services today. Because you have done a lot of work. You see all this decoration and so on. It's not without effort. And actually, kataññu katavedi, this is a word from the Lord Buddha. Saying that actually kataññu katavedi pugala dullabo lokasmin. So actually is here in this world it's very difficult to find a person who are grateful and who is grateful and gratitude, having this gratefulness and gratitude. And this word is very rare and very difficult to find. So this is a word from the Buddha. So example of people to be noted that you must be grateful to your parents, for example, your teacher, and your spiritual teachers, your relatives, even your relatives give you a lot of support and help also. And friends, your good friends. So who help you and give services done to you so that you should not forget them and to be thankful and grateful to them. So now I would like to quote many of these actually Pali words and give the story also here to let me see that actually how the Buddhists actually value so much of this kataññu and katavedi here. For example, today, this morning, our Bhante has sing, I mean, actually not sing, he's recited the gatha that worship father and mother, of mother or father. So, I would like to repeat again in Pali, dasama se ure katoa, o se di uddhi, uddhika vadam, ayudhigam vasat sattam, matu padam nama maha. So actually, in Pali, what is the meaning here? For keeping me in your womb for 10 months, and for protecting and nurturing me so well. So I worship you at your feet, dearest mother. I wish you a blissful and 100 years. So actually, this I got it from where? From the similes, I mean, this, you know, this Sri Lankan chanting book, Pali chanting book. So they thought, I mean, this very, you know, take it very seriously that to educate, to teach the children, to be grateful and thankful to their mother. Now, the first one is mother, the second one, worship to the father. Uthikaro alam aling itua, chum itua ye uttakam, raja macham sukatikam, putta aput pitau, padang nama maha. Itu, father. Here you say, I worship the feet of my father who kisses and caresses me and places me amongst kings when it comes to my work. You see, they realize, you know, the father that's taking care of them, looking after them so much. So therefore, they remember so well. So these, they worship daily, morning and evening. Morning before they go to school, and evening before they go to bed. So they pray to their father and pray to their mother, in remembering of the father and mother that's, you know, so much help to them. So now, following here, kataññu, kataveditâ. Kataññu actually is knowing. Knowing somebody has done something good for to you. Kataveditâ, that means you are giving thanking. That means, like for example, if you give me something, I say thank you. So that thank you, the word and the action that I've done to you, that is rewarding to you. I mean, something that I pay back. So without knowing that you do something good for me, I don't say thank you for you. So because of knowing, so therefore, kataññu and then katavedi, these two words join together, coming together. So I have no words to recount the hardship, dearest mother, you underwent. On my behalf, from the day I was born, I dearly worship you, loving mother. When I cry, you lull me to sleep with deep love and affection. You wash me and cleanse me so carefully. Oh, dearest mother, may you attain nibbana, peace or happiness. So by knowing that the mother has so hardship for taking care in the womb for 10 months of this, you know, little one. So they worship every day to their parent, mother. And now, seeing the father, I have no words to recount the sacrifices, dearest father, you make for my welfare and well-being since my childhood. I deeply worship you, noble father. Whenever I was upset or hurt, you comforted me so tenderly. You care for me and help me in every way possible. Oh, father, loving father, may you attain nibbana peace and happiness. So you see, knowing this value, or I mean this help given by father and mother, so they worship every day. This is how the Sri Lankan Buddhists, they train their children to be so, you know, so that we say that thankful and gratitude. So now I have one picture actually this taken from the Facebook, but it is far for you to see. You know, can you see this small picture here? You can't see it, so I'm sorry because I have not enlarged it. But this one, Actually, a young man from Burma fled to Bangladesh and did not leave his parents who could not move and carried them on his shoulders for 7 days until he arrived to the safe territory. From Burma, they are running away to the same territory, actually going into this Bangladesh. So they are still, you see, the disabled parents, they couldn't walk, two of them. But you know, this young man who carried the shoulder, a basket, two baskets, carrying father this side and carrying mother this side, from Burma, walked 7 days to reach a safe territory, the other country, to the other country, that is Bangladesh. So this kind of thing is happening even today. Because this kind of story, actually, we read it before in the Jataka story or in the Buddhist some places. But we do not really come to this today, this modern world, to see such an event happening today. So therefore, this is very, it's very rare and difficult to find such a person. So, they are still children and with your moral values. Take a good look at this teenage, you must remember him. And remember his face, he carried two people who gave him life on his shoulders for 7 days. So, could you do that? If your parents are disabled, that you carry him for 7 days walking. This picture. So, you see the value still here that we must encourage and then to let the young one to know the value of father and mother. Not only the father and mother, that we must have grateful and gratitude. So here, I give you another Buddhist quoting from here. Actually, it's the king of gods. The Bodhisattva asked the Bodhisattva, if you know about this story here. So for a definition of a good person, what do you define a good person? How can you say this person is a good person or that person is a bad person? So here, yobe kataññu kataveti hero. Those who know Pali, I read it this one, they know, they understand what I see. But those who do not know, I give this translation to you. The wise, who is grateful and thankful. The wise one, who is grateful and thankful. Those who are not wise, they have no gratefulness and thankfulness. So therefore, this is definition given by the Bodhisattva. And second one, kalyana mitto dalha bhakti cha hoti. The spiritual friends who have firm devotion. And then dukkitasya sakkaccha karoti kichyam, respectfully done his duty for one in pain. Tatha vidhan sappurisam katampi. Therefore, such a one is called a good person. So if you want to define a good person, a person who have this gratefulness and thankfulness is actually a wise person. Okay, remember this. And do you want some more? Or is enough? How much that I have to say? Okay, here. Remembering the service. Okay, this elephant renders great service to the king. But once grown old and is neglected and scorned, the Bodhisattva admonishes the king with these verses. So when people have done help to you when they go home and then you just chase them away, that is not a good person. So yo ube katta kalyano katato nava bhujati. He who doesn't acknowledge the good deed that was done in the past, atta asa paru chanti ye humti abhipattita. Whatever his gain so desire, they will surely decrease. So, such kind of ingratitude person, so whatever he gained, he will be going to decline or decreases. Yo ube katta kalyamo katato manut bujjati. He who does acknowledge a good deed that was done in the past. Atta tassa pavattanti onti api pattita. Whatever is gained, so desire, they will surely increase. So whatever that you have gained or is going to gain, so it will increase more and more. So from here on, you can see all this scripture, Buddhist scripture, is talking about thankfulness and gratefulness. So who that we should be thankful and grateful to, actually is not only, you know, to the parents. Just now we have mentioned of our father and mother, our teacher, our spiritual teachers, and, you know, this, even relatives, even whoever, your friends that have done so much good to you. So these people that actually we are thankful to them and grateful to them. So these are the Buddhist training for this gratefulness and gratitude. So now I would not like to take so much time from here, that by ending, give you this conclusion. Last but not least, I would like to thank all of you here and overseas, because some of my friends that they are also looking forward to see this event even. So not only you are here looking at me, so actually that if your life is on, so overseas that many friends are waiting to see. So from overseas, for your one way or another, being my spiritual friends, especially our venerable Talangama Devananda on my side here. So he has given me this opportunity to come forward here to give you a little this talk, and sadhu to you and sadhu to all of you, and thank you very much. And don't forget that the Thanksgiving Day are coming. So it's this November 25th. Is it? November 25th, Thanksgiving Day?
Yes.
That's Thursday. So remember to call your father and mother, and if you can, go back to them and stay with them, and then to thank you, your father and mother, for, you know, all the support. And